Hey fam, I hope that you are all doing good, feeling blessed and abundant. So welcome to the healing space. My name is Prophetess T, and in today's video I have a very special message from the one on your mind, the one that you cannot stop thinking about. I have a message from them. We could even say this is a love letter, you know. And I also feel like saying, you know, chances are if you are listening to this, or you are gonna listen to this, you might not actually be with this person, but you know, just to hear what's in their headspace, because you know, with all this Valentine's, it does get one in their feelings just a little bit. So just to let you know how your person is feeling and spread the love vibes. So I am going to read this letter for you as it was given to me, and I'll just add a little information as we go. Okay, but I'm seeing the numbers 526, so that is letting me know that right now your person is undergoing a change, your person is undergoing a transformation, and they do want to have this love partnership with you. They do want to be with you. They want to invest in this situation. They see it as something worth changing for, you know, because if a person starts to change their ways for you, or they start to see how they didn't treat you right, how they did you wrong, then I feel like sometimes for me that is actually the greatest form of love. You know, changed behavior is much better than someone saying I'm sorry or please forgive me. But once you see that this person has changed, they are doing things in a different way, then you know for real that okay, this is love, this is what I want. So just seeing those numbers lets me know that your person is definitely changing and realizing that this relationship, in its nature, I feel like it's very spiritual. It's a very strong connection, and we have been picking this up for quite some time. So they know that they cannot run away from this. As much as they can, they will always feel as though there is unfinished business with you. You know, a part of them will never feel settled, having not explored what this relationship could have been. I hope that makes sense. So let's get into the letter. So the first thing I heard was, I miss you and I am scared of another failed relationship. It's hard for me to let down my guard and trust people, but something about you makes me feel as though I will be safe and loved. And okay, so this was a bit of a side note. So the side note is just saying that in this situation, when you guys first met each other, there were some red flags that were present. But you know, when you're in love or you are having feelings for someone, the red flags will look a bit purple, they'll look a bit pink, you know, they don't look red. So this is just saying that going forward, don't look at things with rose-colored glasses, but rather see things for what it is. If you see a red flag, speak out on it. Let your person know that this is a bit suspicious, I don't like this, or you know, just have those conversations, because I feel like communication here wasn't really as clear as it should have been. And I might also feel as though your person wants you to give them a pulse. They want to get an indication that you are still interested in them, or that you still love them, because from where they are sitting right now, they feel as though you are out there, you are single, you are mingling, you are living your best life, you know, you are flirting, you're dating, you're having sex. That's all they are thinking about at this time. You know, they just feel like you are living it up without them, you know. So they just want an indication that, you know, you're still on their mind, you still think about them, you still love them, you still want to have something with them. Because I feel like for the both both of you. This separation hasn't been an easy one. It hasn't been easy, but it was necessary. That is how it was supposed to play out. And I definitely feel as well that your person is hoping to have a new beginning. They are hoping to start afresh and build this relationship with you, and they are also hoping that you feel the same way and that you're going to be open to them coming back in and rebuilding. And depending on how the situation ended, you will know your situation much better than me, but depending on how it ended, if there wasn't too much damage that was done, I definitely see that, you know, it is going to be very stable, it's going to be strong, provided you guys now understand each other, understand that, you know, communicating is important, being vulnerable is important, you know, letting go of fear and just understanding that your heartbreak was noted, you know, the things that you went through were noted. So you're not going to go through those same cycles again. And I was recently having a conversation with someone and just saying that the divine has been testing us in such a way that if you are someone who has a large capacity to love, if you have a big heart or you are a giver, your heart was tested in that, you know, you kept attracting people who took advantage of you, who broke you down, who hurt you. And the objective of that test was to see, do you still keep your heart open? Are you still open to love? Are you still open to being vulnerable? Or did you become cold? Did you close your heart off, you know? So I just feel that if you were able to withstand those tests, still believe in love, still believe that your person is out there, your fairy tale romance is still out there, then you pass the test. And when you pass the test, you receive your partner from God. So I definitely feel as though when your person comes, like I said, you are being asked to keep an open mind and not hold on to what happened in the past too much, but, you know, really try to move forward in a fresh way, you know, on this fresh beginning. And I just feel like, you know, maybe they might ask you out or ask you to do something. So keep an open mind. And I also feel as though in this relationship, there might have been some kind of deceptive behavior or some kind of deception. And I'm picking up two kinds of deception. I'm picking up the first deception was that possibly whoever you were dealing with or were dealing with, you know, didn't let you know how deeply they actually loved you, how deeply they actually cared and admired you. You know, I feel like this is something that they kept to themselves, possibly out of fear of rejection or maybe not getting the response that they thought they were going to get, you know. But now they're realizing that they should have just told you how they feel. And I think going forward, they are going to let you know how they feel. The second deception that I am picking up is that, you know, your person did have a third party. I'm hearing third parties. So I just feel that there were multiple people involved in this situation and you were not aware that, you know, they had other people and possibly you didn't know that you were an option at this time. But I think now you know that you were an option. But then in you being an option, you were actually the best option. So it was kind of, I feel as though the tables have turned now. You know, someone really does see your value. They see that no one compares to you. They might have looked for your love in other people only to find that the love that you give, the care that you give, it is not easily found. It is not easily found. And I also picked up, I think this is also going with the deception storyline, but, you know, your person could have been dealing with an ex while they were dealing with you, but I definitely feel that they have released that person because they see now that having that relationship is not worth losing you. They would rather lose that relationship than lose you. So, okay. What did I want to say? I kind of lost my train of thought there, sorry. And yeah, but I definitely feel that, yes, I think as much as, you know, they, you could be dealing with someone who is a little bit possessive, but they hide it quite well, you know. So they are sitting in a bit of a worried vibe. They are a bit worried because they have this feeling, and I just spoke on it now, you know, that you are out there, you are single, you look good, you're a catch, you know. So they feel as though you are going to find someone else, or, you know, someone else is gonna find you, and whoever finds you, they're not gonna hesitate, they're gonna make the move and take you off the scene, you know. So your person is definitely working on themselves during this time. They are healing, they are getting ready for you. I am hearing, you know, I'm coming back, you know, just be patient. So I think they want you to be patient, but then within that, you know, they also want that indication that do you still feel the same way? You know, do you still love them? You know, do you still want to be with them? And I just feel that, you know, they do know who you are, and they understand that you could be the one, or you are the person that they have been seeking. So you are being asked to allow things to progress naturally. And if you are asking for a sign from God, or there was some kind of sign that you have been asking for, the answer is a yes. It's a very big yes. So now that you have received your answer and you know that it is a yes, you are being asked to just go for it and just do it. And I feel like your person does want to apologize for deceiving you. They feel guilty, and they also feel as though they were deceived by a third party. And I think this is also just letting me know that your person might have been making the choice to be in a relationship based on superficial qualities, so looks, beauty, things such as that, you know. And they fell into that trap of maybe being with someone who was more attractive, more beautiful, only to find that there wasn't really any substance, or they didn't get what they thought they were going to get. So this is definitely someone who went out looking for you and other people, and they didn't find you in those people. So they are going to apologize, or they're thinking about apologizing. But the final message from your person is, I love you and you mean the world to me. I value you so much. You made me believe in love again. But I feel like they're coming back better, because I feel like when you dealt with this person, they were a little bit childish, a bit petty, insecure, secretive. You know, they might have liked to cause conflict because they felt a bit of lack within themselves, but now they know that they are destined for great things. They are destined to have fulfilling relationships. And yeah, so this is very interesting. I think this storyline, low-key, I'm a bit tired of it, but we have to understand, you know, sometimes the storyline doesn't change because we are not changing, or the energy is not changing. But once it changes, the message also does change. So apologies if it's a bit redundant, but it is that storyline of the grass wasn't greener, and it never is. The grass is green where you water it. If you do not water your grass, of course it's gonna look brown, it's gonna be dull. But if you water it, you nurture it, you invest in it, you put time into it, you love it, you improve it where you feel like it needs to be improved, then you will have a gorgeous garden. But if you don't, then you will always see other people's gardens being more nicer than your own. And also with this, you don't know how a person is watering their garden. You don't know who is watering that garden. What energy are they watering it with, you know? So don't envy what you see, you know. Be content sometimes with what you have, and put love into it, put energy into it. And yeah, so that is the end of the message from your person. And I wish you a happy Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day. I actually had a song. Your person wanted me to sing for you. And I am. So this song, wow, I don't know if I'm gonna do this right now, but if you wanna tap out of the video right now, you definitely can. But let me just warn you, I have not played the piano in quite a while. And the piano that we have here at home, it is out of tune. It needs to be tuned quite a lot. But there is a song, and this is Stand By Me by... Who is it by? I think it's Ben E. King. So I'm just gonna like sing it for you, because this was also one of the channeled messages. Your person wanted me to play the song for you and sing it for you, and then we're done with the channeled message. So let me just quickly set myself up and I will sing the song for you, and then we will say bye-bye and see each other in our next video. Okay, so now I am positioned. I hope that you guys can hear me. And please don't mind, my piano skills are not the best, and I don't really know the song, but I have to give the message out in completion as it is supposed to come out. So let us go. Try the chorus one more time. If you are still listening, wow, oh my gosh, guys, I think that's why, guys, you need to practice, because wow, this was so impromptu. No more piano messages, please do. Okay, let's try again. I'll just go for that. Darling, darling. Okay, so darling, darling, this video, and I will see you in our next one. Have a blessed day, and I love and appreciate you all so much.